So for decades, meaning, you know, most people have this idea in our minds that there are two types of cholesterol. There's the good cholesterol and the bad cholesterol. And the good cholesterol was thought to be high density lipoproteins or HDL. The bad cholesterol was thought to be low density or in low density lipoproteins or LDL. But we know now from your research and other people's research that it's much, much more complicated than that. And there's actually various sizes and densities of these lipoproteins. Can you explain a little bit about what the various sizes of these lipoproteins are and what they mean for what they do in the body, what their normal function is, and what that means for heart disease risk?
Yes. As you mentioned, cholesterol is part of the LDL, but it's not the whole story. When we measure LDL cholesterol, it's really the summation of cholesterol in a whole series of LDL particles that range from very small and compact or dense LDL to large and people use the word fluffy, which is a term I'm not particularly fond of.
Buoyant.
But it's buoyant. They tend to float more because they actually have more cholesterol and they're larger. So that spectrum of particles we started to break down with methodology that I was fortunate enough to have available to me and helped develop to show that these different forms of LDL across the spectrum really have very different metabolic and pathologic properties. And to keep it relatively simple, we initially categorized those spectrum of particles into two major forms, those that are smaller and more dense versus those that are larger and more buoyant. That somewhat oversimplifies the story, but it does capture an important feature, which was what first attracted our attention to this, and that is that people with a higher heart disease risk and people who have evidence of heart disease tend to have more of the particles that are the smaller and more dense particles, and those individuals that are more healthy tended to have more of the larger, more buoyant LDL. That became somewhat counterintuitive because when we measure LDL cholesterol in the clinic as the summation of cholesterol in all of these particles, we do know that that is related to heart disease risk. LDL cholesterol is a reasonable measure of heart disease risk. But what it turned out is that within these particle profiles that we were studying, the highest risk was related to particles that actually had less cholesterol in them. So it led to a kind of a rethinking of the role of cholesterol. Not that cholesterol is not relevant to heart disease. In fact, it's cholesterol that builds up in the arteries. The question is, how does it get there? And it turns out that even though these smaller particles carry less cholesterol, they do have a greater tendency to wind up in the artery wall. They can be bound more tightly to artery tissue. And once they get into the arteries, they tend to stick. And they tend to be oxidized more rapidly. And all of these features we and others helped to characterize once we discovered this differentiation between larger and small LDL. And it helps to explain the associations that we saw. That is, the particles that are smaller and more dense do bring cholesterol into the arteries, but they have other properties that make them more damaging to the arteries, as I've described, versus the larger LDL that, even though they have more cholesterol, do not have the same pathologic features. And that differentiation, although it was a somewhat oversimplification of what is in fact a much more complicated picture, does carry into the clinic. And so we were able to develop tests that have been used clinically in practice. I think more and more over time, people are appreciating the value of these measurements and thinking more about LDL particles rather than LDL cholesterol.